Whenever we use multiple tables in our document or even across documents, we should make use of table styles to maximize efficiency and also formatting consistency. Word already provides a set of predefined tables which we can access by clicking into a table and switching to the Table Design tab. But before selecting one of the table styles, we should give Word more information about our table structure, since this will open up more designing options. If our table content, for example, contains a title row, then we should check the corresponding box for that. The same goes for the title column, the total row, and the last column. We can additionally also activate banded rows. This will give us the option to format adjacent rows slightly differently, and it will help the reader to stay focused on the same row. Of course, that option is also available for the columns of the table. Once we activated all the options that we want, we can see that the table styles are showing the updated designs. Some designs won't have a highlighting for the specific options, but others will. So we can now choose a style that we like, and the design of the whole table will be done within a single click. In case we don't like any of the default styles, we can create a completely new style, or if one of them already comes close to what we like, then we simply modify it. However, before creating or modifying a table style, ask yourself if you want this style to also be accessible from other documents, because in this case you will have to implement the changes globally in the normal.m file. For that, click on File, Open, and go to the following location. Now open the normal.m template, insert a dummy table, and do all the changes that will follow in here. Once you're done with the changes, you can delete the dummy table, save the template, and then the modified table style will be accessible also in other documents. Since I don't want to change the table style globally, but only for the current document, I will proceed with my standard document. Now, no matter if we choose to create a new table style or modify an existing one, we will see the same window, and with the drop-down Apply Formatting To, we can either change the formatting for the whole table or for the specific areas that can be activated through the table style options. Note that the whole table is always the base of the table design, and the other table style options will override the corresponding areas. So if we want the inner table content to have an italic font style, then in the first step we have to apply this change to the whole table. In the second step, we can remove this change again from the special areas like the header row. Now let's quickly look into all the formatting options that we have here. In the top row, we can change all the font settings, so not only the font itself, but also the font size, the font style, and the font color. In the bottom row, we can select the border type, the border thickness, and the border color. When we click on the little arrow next to the border button, we will be able to select which specific borders should be affected by the new border style. So we can, for example, select bottom border here, and with a click on the borders button, the bottom border will now be updated. And if we again click on that button, the border will be removed in that area. And of course, we can now activate various different border styles for different areas within our selection. Aside from the borders, we can also choose a fill color and the alignment of the text within the cell. And if we want even more formatting options, we can click on Format, and there we'll get access to almost any setting you can imagine. Once we are finished with creating or editing our style, we click into any other table in our document, make sure that the desired table style options are activated again, and now we simply click on our custom table style, and it will also be applied to the second table. And just in case that you have a huge number of tables in your document and you want to apply your new style to all of these tables automatically, then visit the link in the video description below to see my other tutorial on that topic. You will also find a video link in which I explain how to store static tables as a template. If you want to support the creation of these short and efficient videos, then you could do me a huge favor by hitting the like and the subscribe button. Thanks a lot, and I see you in the next one.